I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
A son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you look like when you're all grown up. A lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
Okay?
You one day. We need a doctor, not a deadbeat. Fail to meet my expectations, and there will be...
Don't look straight into the light.
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations,
your future is bright.
Toys in this place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. You can do it. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo. I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. Just stay here while Daddy runs. Show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it?
He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As Overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things, believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10.
Happy birthday!
Enjoying yourself?
Are you having
Attention,
a nice
everyone.
Time?
It's time to top
hey,
the cake!
Hey, happy birthday, Nosebleed! Wait!
Mortified about the cake mishap.
Yeah,
simply
I got
mortified.
One. The Mackers. Super cool.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amada put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. Don't presume too much on her friendship. I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from Old Lady Palmer. How about we share it? What are you, 5? Give me that sweet roll, I'm gonna pound you. Punk. You're gonna be sorry.
You all right, son?
Besides...
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about? That's fine, son. I'm glad to see you're not letting Butch bully you. He's gonna be a handful in a few years if his mother doesn't take him in hand. Well, no harm done then. Why don't you get back to enjoying your party?
As that friend of yours could use a reminder that life is not all fun and games.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What are you two best friends?
Supposed
to be a
party. You know, you can be sweet girl now. This party's pretty good, I guess, for a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks, and we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh right, you weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Jonas, happy birthday. Sorry I couldn't be at your party. Listen, would you put your dad on?
How about Hell's Overseers?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Lovely.
I like that.
You did such a splendid job.
Well,
Jonas?
Your name in it
hey, Doc.
Which makes it better than any of your other ideas.
Thanks. I'll send him right
Hello,
down.
Officer Gomez.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Yes, I'm glad you could make it.
I'm glad to be here. I think it's important to keep in touch with the young people, you know.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. Oh, boys will be boys, won't they? Just can't wait to see your present, is that it? Well, let's not keep you waiting any longer. I think you're going to like it. It's a poem written by me just for you. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a...
Part of my job, plus, well, I like parties.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that.
Old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me.
What do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. I'll make sure to thank him.
Happy birthday, buddy. Hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10.
Hey.
Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me at the big game.
Smile.
Boys and girls have different parts.
That is her part right? Anyway. So, I'm the overseer's daughter. So what? That like, I get any right. Kind of special
tell
treatment.
Me. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam.
Something you're worried about?
Back
off! Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
Don't mess with the... What? You mouthing off, Spaz? Everyone knows the tunnel snakes. We rule this vault, and we don't take shit from nobody. Not you, not her, and not her daddy, the overseer. Why don't you mind your own business? Last I... Run along, kid, before Butch and I decide you're a problem. Stay out of this. It's tunnel snake business. Me and Butch, we're just having... I don't follow anyone. Wally Mack is his own man, and the Tunnel Snakes is where I belong. Why? You think Butch is in charge? Is that what people are saying? Because it's a load of shit if that's what they're saying. What? What kind of shit is that? No one talks that way about Wally Mack. He's not the boss of me. Nobody's the boss of me. I'm out of here. No, we're done here.
Get done. These idiots away
we're not
from me.
Done. This
don't know
is
who
an
put you in charge.
This
I think
is
we're
over,
done.
Punk.
Let's go.
Tunnel snakes rule. None of your business. Because Butch said... Tunnel snake... Because he's my pal. My brother. All us tunnel snakes are brothers. Birth to earth. Womb to tomb. Mostly because tunnel snakes... That's us. No one mess... Can't think of anything. Butch says this little bitch is blabbing to her daddy about us tunnel snakes. Because
we... Paul.
Are you sure?
Butch, here we go. Stop it! Leave him alone!
I've got
this
ain't
God,
over, huh? Daddy.
I've got your back.
Come on,
hit
tunnel
him again.
Snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time. Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine. Let's go.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess?
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question 1. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question 2. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Indisputably the most important person involved, 101. He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Hello.
Interesting. Clinical test subject. Sounds like something you should excel at. I guess you and your dad will be working together. Ha! Closer to reality than you might think. Listen, I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously, and look where I ended up. Just between you and me. The whole test is a joke. If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know.
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
Anything is possible, even an A.
That
Mr. Brotch.
Is he here to save you now? Is he having to get back to work? Selfish and insubordinate.
Wake up! Come
you
on,
need to
wake
know
up!
These things. I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you. He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men. They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now. Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. Not anymore, apparently. But are you honestly telling me you had no idea your dad was leaving? He really didn't tell you? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you... Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me. Good luck.
Holy right there! So I hate rat roaches. So what? I tried to go back in to help her. I swear I did. But I just can't do it. So I'm begging you, please help her. I don't know what I'd do without my mom.
Jonas, I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry. I thought about it for a long time, but in the end, I decided it was best for you not to know. So many things could have gone wrong, and there's really no telling how the Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. It was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay, go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
My father wasn't himself. I don't know what he might have done if you hadn't come along. You'd better get out of here. I'll try to meet you at the vault door. If I don't make it, good luck. You opened the door! My God, I almost didn't believe it was possible. No, you didn't need me. If anyone can survive out there, it's you. It's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do. I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense into my father. Listen, if you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for... for, you know, Jonas and my father and everything.
We'll be right back.